It's currently about 4 in the morning. Today we've got approximately 15 people coming, leaving from the Houston SPCA, going to a place out west where there's multiple bears and tigers.
They're taking with them a team of veterinarians from the Houston Zoo, led by Dr. Joe Flanagan.
We went out and visited the site on Friday, and each individual is housed in a cage, essentially a wire cage that is roughly 5 feet by 8 feet in dimension. And they have enough room to turn around, and that's about it.
These are beautiful, smart animals that have been living these solitary lives in these very small cages. Most of the bears have not even been able to stand up for the last 9 years inside those cages, and that's why we need to get them out of there.
Ahead of them is a journey of 200 miles. By daybreak, they arrive in southwest Texas, just a few miles from the target location. Waiting to brief them is the county constable, Ken Hedrick.
We'll go as a caravan to the property. I will enter the property first, make sure that the owner of the animals is not present. I'll open the gate. Everyone will come in. The gate will be locked again. And once we're all in the property, we'll proceed and remove the animals as best and as rapidly as we can.
The property they're heading for is a chicken shed on the edge of town. When they arrive, there's no sign of the owner. They're met by lots of dogs. But the dogs are the least of their worries. Inside the shed, in cramped cages, are two tigers and 11 bears. The Houston SPCA investigators survey the scene in stunned silence, taking photos of every single animal.
This is absolutely insane. I have never seen anything like this. It is amazing and a once-in-a-lifetime experience, but pretty scary.
Well, the animals that are in these cages are way too small for these types of animals to be in. They're wild animals are used to having a large expanse of territory, and they're living in a cage about the size of a piece of plywood, 4 by 8 foot, entirely too small for them. In the summertime, this particular facility that these animals were in would constitute, as far as I'm concerned, torture. There's not a whole lot of airflow around here, and you have a high degree of heat that can build up, and without the lack of airflow and without any water, there's not a lot for these animals can do but suffer.
The bears, including two fully grown grizzlies, have spent their whole lives in cages where they hardly have enough room to turn around. Until a few years ago, the animals were put on display at state fairs and other public events. They're being seized because the owner failed to comply with local wild animal licensing laws.
All of them appear to be having stress behavior. They're anxious, biting at the cage. The tiger's starting to get anxious and roaring at people when they come close. They're not used to other people, so this is a very stressful thing to them to see all these people around. It makes me really sad. A lot of these bears' claws are extremely overgrown. Their teeth are worn down from chewing on the cages. There's no water available for them, and we're in South Texas. It gets very hot.
When we were out here a few days ago, he showed us the way he gives water. He'll walk down the corridor and then squirt water from a water hose, and the animals come up to the side of the cage and cling to the side of the cage with their mouths open, asking for water. They've lived in these tiny, tiny spaces for at least 9 years. And one of the bears is 31 years old. He's had most of them since they were cubs. These animals have been used in performances in the past for several decades, and have lived a miserable life. But today's the lucky day.
The Houston SPCA president, Patty Mercer, anxiously watches over every move.
This is not a personal mission, it's a mission of the Houston SPCA, because we're all about all animals. And this county that asked for help is 200 miles from Houston, but we saw the conditions of these animals and we could not say no. We had to help them.
We can start on the exotic aspect of it.
The Houston SPCA's chief investigator, Charles Jansen, prepares the cages that will be used to transport the exotics.
All right, so do we have some strapping?
Yeah.
Vets from the Houston Zoo are hoping that Ivan the tiger will walk from one cage to the other of his own free will. The signs are not encouraging. They don't want to anesthetize him unless they have to. Dr. Flanagan is keeping a close eye on him to make sure he doesn't get too upset.
Sometimes animals don't want to leave their enclosure. They are safe, they're secure. Look at all these strange people, they've never seen them before. I know nobody ever bothers me here, I'm safe. If I go over there, I might not be safe. So that's a very possible scenario that's going through his head.
After another 20 minutes of gentle coaxing, Ivan still refuses to move. The cage is way too small, but he regards it as home. He's getting increasingly agitated, so Dr. Flanagan calls an immediate halt to their efforts.
All right, let's go help over here, Charles.
Okay. Other animals, you see an open door, they'll go through it. So in this case, he didn't, and we were going to stress him out. And anesthesia is a very nice thing. He's not feeling any pain.
He'll be moved once they're sure the anesthetic has taken full effect. Next up, it's the first of the bears.
Anybody who doesn't want to be stuck in here with the bears should leave. All righty.
I'm ready. Let's go.
Yeah.
There you go.
He proves to be much more cooperative.
Good job. Hey, nice job.
It remains a dangerous situation. An armed guard stands by in case any of the animals escape.
Basically for everyone's protection, the animals are being given the proper types of drugs to sedate them and let them be more at ease and easier for us to handle. But for any reason that an animal may get out, of course, we'll need more firepower at that time.
You got to be really, really careful and cautious, and can't really take any chances. But they're really, really neat creatures.
This may be more than a 400-pound tiger.
Well, he didn't get that much drug, so. You guys are in there with him.
Thanks.
The tiger is a dead weight, and it takes 9 people to carry him.
We'll go in one trailer
and we need,
together.
And those are all smaller crates.
None of these animals will ever be released into the wild. I mean, they're human imprinted, and they depend on people at this point. The best we can hope for them is that we can place them in reputable sanctuaries around the country. And at that point, their lives will turn around. And we're hoping that we can provide them with the last years of their life with something really good.
The owner has not appeared yet. It's not entirely impossible that he may not show up.
He should be home by now, normally. So we're suspicious that maybe someone said, there's something going on at your place, and he realized he shouldn't come home.
The animal's journey to a new life gets underway. Some of them will go to sanctuaries in Texas, California, and Florida. Others will be given temporary homes at the Houston SPCA shelter and at the Houston Zoo.